Hi, I'm Joan Cartan-Hansen, and welcome to Science Trek. I've got some guests with me today, Maya and paleontologist LJ Krummenecker. We're going to go hunting for dinosaurs. Let's go. So why have no real big dinosaur finds been found in Idaho?
That's a good question. You think of places like Utah or Montana where you have your big, giant, you know, ridiculous dinosaurs. And I think that's, for a long time, people came out here expecting to see that, and we didn't. And I think part of the reason for that is probably there was some sort of process going on as these rocks formed where big bones didn't get buried fast enough to get preserved. They just rot away and get destroyed. When you're looking for dinosaur bones, you need to find rocks of kind of the right age from the age of dinosaurs.
You also need to look near rivers or streams. And Krummenecker found something here.
So right here's the vertebra poking out of the rock, just starting to come out with probably, hopefully, more bones in.
We're joined by fellow paleontologist Ashley Ferguson.
I'm going to have to peck around in some of these cracks and see how helpful the rock is, see if we can get it out. This is a tail bone, probably from this little dinosaur living in its burrow called a rictodromius. It's the most common Idaho dinosaur. It's a plant eater. Maybe 10, 11 foot long, about 7 foot tail, ran around on two legs, and again, it lived in the burrows with its kids. Trying to avoid damaging it right now. I'm just trying to see where we might have some loose cracks to work around it and hopefully get it out in one piece. I mean, if it comes out in two or three decent pieces, it's not bad.
Yeah.
Trying to dig it out. The rock's really hard, so I'm going to have to come back and put a lot more work into it. We also found another bone poking out, so I suspect as we get into this, if we're lucky, we'll have a partial skeleton.
So we decide to move to another site. This time, we're looking for dinosaur eggshells.
Looks like there's an eggshell piece there. Oh, nope, never mind. That's a rock.
Keep looking. There'll be more. There are.
There's a small piece.
Here's a little piece of eggshell.
Really? Oh,
yep,
there's a good piece.
Is there one
right here?
Yep, good
yep,
eyes.
Nice.
You're doing good.
Oh, there's a nice piece. See how bumpy they are? Mm-hmm. Kind of weird, huh?
These eggs are from an oviraptorsaur.
Imagine like a big chicken with fingers and claws and kind of a long feathered tail that might eat you. We call it the killer chicken or the boneless chicken because we find the eggs, but we haven't been able to find the bones.
Eggs are important because it helps us learn how the animal grew and how they care for their young. It's a way to learn how the animal lived. So in a way, for me, it's important because it makes the animals more real.
Good job, Maya. You found a lot.
The dinosaur eggshells will be taken to the Idaho Museum of Natural History for study. We go on to our last dinosaur site of the day.
So where we're standing right here, you wouldn't have any idea this is the most important, well, at least one of the most important dinosaur spots we found in Idaho. It's called the Robeson Bone Bed.
The Forest Service was going to put a road through this area when Krummenecker found dinosaur bones.
You've got out here teeth from ancestors of T-Rex. You got little raptor teeth. Even a little tiny raptor tooth from some sort of raptor the size of a crow. Of course, you've got a lot of erictodromius bones.
So the Forest Service set aside the rocks from the hillside and put them in a field for paleontologists to study.
Big problem is when they first dumped all the rock here, it was actually piles of rock. That's all that was here. But the past 3-4 years, it's just totally overgrown with plants. So every year it gets harder and harder to work here.
So you can see between having to chisel fossils out of a stone or finding rocks hidden by plants, a paleontologist's work isn't easy. But Krummenecker says he loves it.
If I was 8 or 10, like one of my kids thinking about becoming a paleontologist, I would probably think one of the best things about it is you get to play outside all day in the summer. So you get to travel. If you're lucky, you're gonna get paid for what you're doing. You get to meet other students and teach other people. I like teaching. So it's a good way to play outside, good way to learn, and a good way to meet other people.
You can learn more about dinosaurs by checking out the Dinosaur Site on the Science Trek website. You'll find it at idahoptv.org/sciencetrek. We'll see you next time on Science Trek.
So the butt slide is one of the best ways to get down it. But...
remember where I was.
Now, did I say it right?
Yep, you're good.
Presentation of Science Trek on Idaho Public Television is made possible through the generous support of the Laura Moore Cunningham Foundation, committed to fulfilling the Moore and Bettis family legacy of building the great state of Idaho. By the Idaho National Laboratory, mentoring talent and finding solutions for energy and security challenges. By the Friends of Idaho Public Television, and by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting.